maximize orbital overlap between the HOMO and LUMO domains, the 3-3 sigmatropic rearrangement proceeds through a chair-like transition state. This is easily seen with the animation that you can find hyperlinked to your notes. It's in a JMOL, so you can rotate it until you can find an orientation that's the way that you need to view it to see this chair-like transition state. The animation stops at the transition state structure, and you should be able to begin to see how it resembles a chair-like conformation. The new sigma bond is going to be formed between those two atoms. If we run it through to completion, you'll see that sigma bond form, and the pi bond emerges, a pair of pi bonds emerge on the other side. A consequence of this concerted chair-like transition state means that there are two ring-flipped forms through which the reaction might proceed. Take the case of this Claisen rearrangement. This methyl group is attached to an sp3 hybridized carbon, and there are two ways to fold the terminal positions of this double bond in order to meet this chair-like transition state. In one way, the methyl group is placed in an equatorial-like position, and in that case, you can see that the new double bond that's going to result is going to have an E double bond geometry. The E double bond geometry will emerge faster because that places the methyl group in an equatorial position in the transition state. Compare that to the case where we would fold the double bonds in a way to bring their faces together that puts the methyl group in an axial position. In this case, you can see that this substituent is on the same side, is heading in the same direction as the methyl group, and so the result there is that we get the Z double bond. That's going to be the slow reaction because that transition state puts the methyl group in the more unfavorable position, the axial position. Although it's a little tricky to perform, the frontier orbital analysis for the 3-3 sigmatropic rearrangement predicts this chair-like transition state. The reason the analysis is difficult is because the two pi systems are separated by the sigma bond that undergoes migration. And so when we break this molecule up into HOMO and LUMO domains, as we've been doing, we're going to have to include as part of the LUMO not only the sigma bond that breaks, but also one of the pi bonds. It doesn't really matter how you break them up, but we're going to have to make sure that when we do our analysis of the LUMO, it includes both a sigma bond as well as a pi bond. I'll show you how to do this analysis, but you're not going to be held accountable for it. We're going to recognize that there's a new pi bond that's formed there between the HOMO and the LUMO domains, and so whatever lobes we end up choosing for the two positions that are connected there, we're going to make sure that they're phase matched. So let's just go and look at that. That's the sigma star lobe that's there, and it's matched in phase to the pi HOMO of ethylene. For the HOMO domain, we're just going to borrow from the HOMO of ethylene, and so that will put matched phases on the two terminal positions. And then for the tricky part of the molecule, the LUMO domain, we're going to make an analogy to the nodal pattern in the LUMO of butadiene. That's another four-atom system that we know the molecular orbitals for. The nodal pattern of the LUMO of butadiene places a node between the last two positions. That would be the consistent with the sigma star orbital that we have in this case. And then the nodal pattern for the LUMO of butadiene has matched phases in the center two atoms, and the nodal pattern for the LUMO of butadiene has a node in the last two positions, and so we have a phase inversion. As a consequence, you can see that in this chair-like transition state structure, there is perfect sigma-type orbital alignment with matched phases between the two terminal positions. And it's for this reason that the 3-3 sigmatropic rearrangement undergoes its reaction through a chair-like transition state. In the series of webcasts that involve the sigmatropic and electrocyclic ring opening reactions, we've done a frontier orbital analysis in which we've broken the molecule into HOMO and LUMO domains. And this picture has predicted accurately the stereochemistry and the reactivity of the substrates that undergo these reactions.